What is it,
Father? Father, I've gone the wrong way, Father. I've fallen straight off the path.
My son, we open our services tomorrow morning, sunrise.
Come on. No, Father, please, Father, don't. Do not abandon me, Father, please, stop.
My son. My child, it can't be all that.
You don't understand. You don't understand this. I raped a woman, Father. I raped a woman, Father, please, no. No, Father.
No, please. No, please. Please get up. It'll be okay. It'll be okay.
Father, forgive me. Oh, it's been so long since my last confession.
My child, please stand.
You don't understand. You don't understand, Father. Oh, I'm a whore, Father. I've sinned. I've fornicated. You don't understand, Father. I've fornicated so many times. I'm a sinner, Father.
No, my child.
Father, forgive me. Father, for I have sinned.
You gotta help her, Angel. It's all right, Lizzie. I'm not raping you.
Okay, you know what? No.
Enterprise. I'm sick of this shit.
It's alright, baby. I'm here for you, baby. I'm not raping you. I'm alright, baby. I'm alright, baby.
Fans, welcome to XPW TV. My name is Chris Kloss. Now, episode 98. It is. That means just around the corner. I can't believe it. We're going to be celebrating XPW. XPW TV will be celebrating episode 100. This is the I can't believe it's been that long. Episode 100 will be airing the week after the big show from the Pico Rivera Sports Arena, Liberty or Death, and for the big spectacular, I've been told, well, there might be some shady activity going on, if you know what I mean. Now, for that episode, I'm going to be joined by my co-host. How I got stuck with him, I don't know, but I know I'm stuck with the dude. And for some weird reason, they call him Juan Tastico.
Suave.
Episode 100, Klaus, huh? 1 week after Liberty or Death? That means episode 100 is 1 week after Pogo and I advanced to the semifinals in the tag team title tournament.
You know, I gotta say, Juan Tastico, it's nice not having to drive around all over the Southland trying to locate you through the metro, trying to find you. Yeah, thanks a lot for joining us here in the studio this week.
Well, you're welcome.
Yeah.
You're lucky you're in my presence.
Dodo.
Hey, cuidado.
I was driving all over the place.
Listen, Klaus, everybody, and I'm sure the fans agree with me, everybody needs a little rest and relaxation now and again. You should try it sometime, seriously. Maybe it'll stop you from being such a butthole.
You better watch it, pal. You better watch it. I'm warning you. I've been here for 100 episodes, and you haven't. Now, on a serious note, when we went off the air last week, we saw one of those dames that you were escorting out of the club, the very shady club. I would never partake in activities like that. Anyway. What happened was, when we went off the air, the same girl that you were escorting out of the club, well, she was taking a stroll out of the club down the street and then brutally attacked by the very bizarre acting lately, GQ Money. Now, Kate, we didn't see the whole, what came out of that. We didn't see the end of that footage. But however, KJLA determined that it was too controversial even. Too extreme for XPW TV.
I know you're absolutely right, Chris. It was a disgusting act by a disgusting individual, a poor excuse for a human being. GQ Money attacking one of the ladies that did nothing but show me an incredible time, a lovely evening. What's the significance of that? That guy's sick. Sick. Something's seriously wrong with him.
Well, you know, not purposely switching gears, but I'm gonna do it right now, pal. And I'm talking about the big announcement we heard last week for the main event sign at Liberty or Death. Webb will be defending the XPW World Heavyweight Championship against the living legend, Terry Funk. He's here, he's back in XPW, and I predict a new champion at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
Incredible, phenomenal. Chris, I'm gonna be torn. I mean, I gotta choose sides between one of the greatest champions in all of wrestling history. When? Webb? It's either Webb or the living legend, the hardcore icon, Terry Funk. I'm torn, man. I don't know which way to go, but I'll tell you this. It will be Webb's hardest match today.
Fans, don't go anywhere, because when we return, we're going to take you back to Genocide and the Genocide match itself, plus some XPW history from the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
Hey, money, 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 money,
money!
What's up?
What's up, superstar?
What's up, B? What did you guys do? Hey. Check this out.
What are you doing, brother?
Check it out, the studio.
The studio's tight.
Hey, studio got a swing.
Come on,
check
bro.
It out. Look.
Come on, let's not do that schoolyard stuff, dude. We got to do some business here, bro. We're going to make some music. We're going to make some magic. We're going to make it right now, tonight, bro. Come on, bro. Let's get together, man. You got to get those juices flowing, Shady. Shady, get those juices flowing. You know what I'm talking about?
For sure. I'm about to get this done. Yeah, I'm about to drop this track.
You better watch yourself, man. I don't want to get no Tupac action out here. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? We gotta keep our security rolling with us. Let's go, bro. Let's check this out.
Shady's in the house.
Yeah, this place be the bomb.
What up, dog?
I got right here. Where's my man at? My main man.
What's happening, man? How you doing,
what's up, man?
Good to see you. This place is looking good,
hey, man.
Looking good. Hey,
sounded good.
Do something different with the hair. Looking good, brother. Groovy, my man. Hey, we're gonna make some music tonight. This boy Shady, with my guidance, AWC. This boy is gonna be rocking. He's the next big thing, man. This is Shady in the house. We're giving you the first chance to put him on CD. The first chance to mix it up. So let's make it tight the way you can do it.
Let's do it.
Lace these tracks.
Let's talk tag teams, Tastico.
We should talk tag teams. You know what? It is a good thing there are only 8 teams in the tag team tournament.
Then maybe you'll have a chance.
No. I'm saying it's a good thing because that only leaves 7 other teams. 14 people total. That's not a lot of people for me to have to apologize to after I kick their asses and win the tag team title tournaments along with my big boy, Polo.
Well, we just have only 2 weeks to go until Liberty or Death. Now, 3 teams have been announced for the tournament, which will take place the first round that night. And of course, the winners advancing to the semifinals, along with the match for the gold, will be taking place Saturday night, July the 20th. But let's not get ahead of ourselves
right
now.
Wait a minute. No, that's a good thing. Let's get ahead of ourselves. That means July the 20th, That's only 3 weeks till me and Pogo go home with the titles.
Fans, other than this guy, you're not gonna wanna miss Liberty or Death taking place Saturday night, June the 29th, from the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. This is gonna be big, and there's all sorts of stuff going on. I mean, we got the main event. Terry Funk is returning to XPW. He's gonna be going against Webb for the XPW World Heavyweight Championship. And of course, this still a mystery up in the air, pal. This apparent bomb that's supposed to... God knows what's
landmine.
Going on.
Landmine.
Whatever you want to call it. And, of course, the tournament begins for the XPW Tag Team titles. Now, tickets are on sale right now for this spectacular. You can call the XPW box office at 818-755-8757. Or you can come on down to the box office located at 11133 Van Owen Street, Suite Letter D in North Hollywood. Go to xpwrestling.com and you can also get them through Ticketmaster. Call them up at 213-480-3232. Go to Ticketmaster.com or any Ticketmaster outlets right here in the good old Southland. Of course, the big one. XPW presents Liberty or Death, coming to you live Saturday night, June the 29th at 8 p.m. from the Pico Rivera Sports Arena in the heart and soul. That's right, of Pico Rivera. And don't forget, folks, the return of Terry Funk here in XPW. Fans, Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Hello?
Hello?
Chris?
Yeah.
Chris Hamrick?
Yeah.
Chris Hamrick?
Yeah.
Chris Hamrick, do you know who this is? Chris Hamrick? Chris Hamrick, do you know who this is? You say you're dumb son of a b-. That's what you are. You're nothing but a dumb son of a b-. And you're nothing but a bitter old man. You're never going to be like me. You're never going to be the sweet young stallion that I am. The television champion that I am.
Who is this?
Who is this?
Who are you, brother?
I'll tell you who this is. This is the Rock Superstar Chaos, and I'm telling you this, Hamrick. I'm gonna take care of you. I took care of
you. What is he laughing at, brother?
I'll take care of you three times. It doesn't make a difference because you're old. I'm bigger than you. I'm younger than you. I'm better looking than you.
You got better things to do than this, too, Superstar.
Than this.
Chris,
no, you see, Chris Hamrick, I'm the one telling you how it is, and I'm telling you, the Rock Superstar is gonna reign victorious, and I'm gonna show you why I'm simply the best.
Hit him, brother! You're not gonna hit him? You're not gonna hit him?
Hit the phone?
You're not gonna hit him?
The phone.
Brother, what are you doing? Hit him! This isn't a joke, brother! This isn't a joke! This isn't a prank phone call, brother! This isn't a prank phone call, brother! No!
Oh!
Like you've never seen a rapper wrestler before. It's balls all up on hoards, like an extreme off the door. Taking chicks to the limit upon a forced entry. Sock them in the stomach, send them down to a bent knee. Yo, it's a debut of, hold up, stop the cut, right? Yo, you're kidding. He didn't just say that, right? He's ribbing. And A-Dub-Z said, nothing you smoke and my ex is dead. Okay, he's not, he's just wasted. All the fans, yo, they love my street style. Give him a thumbs up, have a coke and a smile. Always walking around like I'm a big hot shot.
Yo, man, check this out, brother. That wasn't on the beat at all.
What are you talking about?
You gotta tell yourself, there's a beat for a reason, man. Hit the beat.
I got it.
Hit the beat. Let's go.
I got you.
Sometimes life around you suck real bad. And sometimes you wanna beat the f*** out your dad. Sometimes you wanna just jump in the ring.
I know you're mad, but this is the Titans. We're talking about gold, platinum, international sales. Your name on the bottom, produced by Glenn X.
Please stand up.
You want to invest in this guy a little bit? It's looking good, brother. It's on there, man.
Yeah? It's platinum?
I see a moon man.
Platinum?
I see a moon man going your direction.
Nice.
Do what I can.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Shady.
Yeah, what's cracking?
Ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's talk for a minute, Rico, about the condition, the state of being Rob Black and Lizzie Borden are in at this particular moment in time. I mean, Saturday night, June the 29th, well, at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena for Liberty or Death, it was supposed to be a celebration of sorts. I mean, the triumphant return of Rob Black. However, after the brutal attack that he suffered at his own home due to the Enterprise and the horrific beating Black took from Chaos, well, his progress has seemed to regress. And there will be no celebration Saturday night, June the 29th. And Lizzie Borden, I mean, She seems so traumatized. She may need some medical professional help after that. It doesn't seem like she's going to be leaving the house anytime soon.
You know, this is a feud that has gone way too far. The Black Army, the Enterprise. As you remember, it all started last October when we were first going to the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Veronica Kane, in an attempt to get Chaos out of a title defense, tried to seduce Robert Black.
I remember that.
Much to the disagreement of Lizzie Borden. Huh. And you know what they say about a woman scorned. You know what they say, right?
What are you getting at?
Well, what do you think? Ever since then, because of these two women, this feud has exploded. It has gotten out of control. All hell is broken loose. Anyways, getting back to last October, when we went to the Pico Rivera Sports Arena for the first time. At that time, the psycho guy that you see around here now, GQ Money, was still somewhat normal. He was still the agent to the stars. At that time, he was forced to wrestle his first ever XPW match against none other than Angel.
And what a match that was.
At Halloween in Hell 2 from the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Fans, let's go back. Take a look at that action.
Watching throughout the world here, XPW, international fans watching us from Canada, from Germany, Italy, and England. We want to welcome you all as we present the second Halloween in Hell 2 from Southern California. Go behind from GQ Money. Now a reversal by Angel. Look at the quickness of these two, Rivera.
Oh, no. Oh,
look at that.
No.
Go behind. Go behind.
Oh, I just got the EGBGs back here. Oh.
Imagínate,
you see what Angel just did, the money.
You act like you never seen the song set.
Oh.
What's the matter with you? Tranquilate, Jake.
Going downstairs now, GQ Money, but it's a side headlock applied by Angel. Look at this, rollover, side headlock. Angel still holding onto it, but it's GQ Money going for the pin, only two. Money going for the leg scissors now. Another counter by Angel. Oh, look at that bridge. Beautiful. GQ Money going for a powerbomb. No, another counter by Angel. Look at this.
There is the Gordy special made famous by Gordy Guerrero.
Into the sunset flip. No, only two again.
Patriarch of the Guerrero family.
Oh, look at this double drop kick. Neither man connecting on that one. Clothesline, duck underneath. Clothesline, another duck underneath. Both men, oh, wow. Yeah, double clothesline. Both men go down.
High impact maneuver, sending both men crouching. Did you hear the impact?
The impact, you can hear it all throughout the Pico Rivera Arena and all throughout Pico Rivera.
The ducks in the back heard that.
Well, they're quacking away. Another side headlock from Angel. Across the rope, no. Angel wrenching away now on that side headlock. Money with that heel kick. Oh, look at that. Lifts Angel up, drops the cash flow. He just nailed Angel with the cash flow, Rivera. He's going for the pin. One, two. Oh, look at Crack coming in, breaking the count.
Crack obviously seeing that Angel need his assistant. You know, Chico, that's just the consequence of this relationship.
Angel needed Crack's assistance. Crack needs Angel's ass. Whoa, wait a minute. GQ Money, look at this, from behind grab. Springboard from the top.
Wow.
High cross body. Right across Crack and Angel. And did you see the elevation, Rivera? Motivational speaker TJ Rush coming over to the assist of the agent to the stars, GQ Money.
And now Crack and Angel are rolling around in this mix of dirt and who knows what, horse crap.
A lot of duck poo. Drop down, look at this, leapfrog by GQ Money. Oh, look at that beautiful Japanese arm dragon. Angel goes down.
Beautiful exhibition by these two of nice scientific type wrestling right here. Pico Rivera Sport Arena.
Duck underneath, clothesline, look at that, somersault, rollover, springboard, leg scissors, look at that, hurricane run, a takedown. From GQ Money onto Angel, and Angel goes to the outside, onto the dirt floor, as motivational speaker TJ Rush really going after Angel, as Veronica Kane looks on.
Veronica Kane with a hand in the pocket.
A beautiful move, baseball slide into a hurricane run from GQ Money, what a move that was, Rivera.
Beautiful move.
Wait a minute, Crack back coming once again to the assist of Angel.
This is just a third bit.
Once again, the double team from the Enterprise Rivera. You got two very dirty teams pitted against each other in a very dirty place.
Chico, look at this new cowboy boot I'm wearing as a gift from the Robert Black. Whoa!
Look at that.
Angel.
Tumbleweed from the top, right on top of GQ Money and TJ Rush. Those boots are new.
You think I'm going to go out in this dirt and ruin this boot? That look.
Those boots look like they've been used in the episodes of Dukes of Hazzard. Look how old those are. And look at the back of GQ Money. Look at all the dirt and the duck poo-poo. Shot by Angel. Angel, say what you want about this guy. When it comes down to it, he can wrestle with the best of them at XPW. Oh, look at that, the neck. Did you see the neck? Oh, no. Do I have to look at this, Rivera?
Wow.
What a move by Angel. Catapulted himself up and over and dropped the leg on the back of the neck of GQ Money. Hoisted over that bottom rope. What a maneuver. It cracks 11-2.
Angel and GQ Money putting on a great display here in the opening match for the... Wow! Big clothesline almost taking the head of the GQ Money.
Oh, no, he's doing the Angel job! He's doing the Angel job! This is sick!
And covering the eye.
Yeah. Look at those shots to the head now. Plus the bathhouse bomb from Angel. A reverse senton bomb from the second rope. Oh, look at that. Motivational speaker, TJ Rush.
TJ Rush grabbing the ankle and a direct collision between the groin of Angel and the ring post.
And look at Crack, look very concerned, eyeing the groin of Angel.
While that may have been painful to most of us, I'm sure Angel derived some kind of pleasure.
What are you talking about,
that,
Rivera?
That move.
Look at this. To the top now, GQ Money. Oh, look at that rocker dropper from the top, driving Angel's head smack down to the canvas. And now it's GQ Money eyeing Angel. Look at the big leg drop with the momentum from the near side. And now he's going for the pin. And once again, it's Crack interrupting the count, Rivera.
He's Crack. He's on fire tonight. He must have, some guy in the crowd must have looked at Angel a funny way.
Oh, no! Oh, it's the circumciser! It's the circumciser! Angel!
What? Circumciser?
In GQ Money's case, it's the breast! Unbelievable, man! Crack once again! Look at the smile on his face! Inverted atomic drop from Angel onto GQ Money! And now look at this! Look out, GQ Money! Bulldog!
Whoa.
No, what a counter that was! From GQ Money, slamming Angel into the far side!
This Angel must have a private part made of steel.
Oh, wait a minute. Motivational speaker TJ Rush with that steel chair handing it into GQ Money. What is this? Money planting it down smack dab in the center of the ring.
GQ Money looking to end this match once and for all.
As Angel still trying to regroup from that slam in the far side. Irish whip. Oh, look at this. Fireman's carry. High above his head. Oh, Michinoku driver. And down goes Angel on that steel chair, Rivera. One, two, only two again.
You know, Chris Cross is a real change about this match. The fact that the outside interference has prevented these two from having a pure classical technical match that I was beginning to enjoy. Truly enjoy, Chick.
What are you talking about?
But this TA Rouge, this crack, is ruining for everybody.
Oh, reverse DDT right on top of that steel chair. GQ Money setting up his own demise with that chair. What is Veronica Kane doing to the referee?
This is what I'm talking about.
Angel going upstairs.
Look at those knives.
Look at him. Look at Angel going upstairs. Don't. Oh, God. I'm losing my lunch.
Oh.
It's the Flying Fairy.
What?
Angel just nailed GQ Money with the Flying Fairy. And now, oh no, wait a minute, from behind. Motivational speaker TJ Rush with a chair shot to the back. Look at him still. The referee distracted. Oh wait, crack, look at crack. He's going for the cracker jack. He's going for the crack. Oh, and he nailed him. Crack nailed him with the cracker jack right there.
Hey.
What the hell is Dorko Dude doing here? With all his might, a chair shot to the head right between the eyes. Kevin Kleinrock running for his life. Referee down. Three. It's over. Angel got the three count, Rivera.
Little fishies. Hey, look at me when I'm talking to you. How you guys doing? You doing good? You look good. You happy? Huh? You look happy. Well, you know what? I'm happy too. You know why? Huh? Because I saved Lizzie Borden. That's right. Hip hip hooray for Scott Snot. They're throwing parades for me every day here. In fact, Rob Black might even start paying me what I'm worth. Oh yeah, Rob Black, that's right. He went and got himself hurt again. Well, hopefully he'll be in that wheelchair a long, long time. And you know what I'm going to do while he's in that wheelchair? I'm going to look after Lizzie. Because see, when she gets better, when she starts getting out of bed again and start moving around, she's going to need someone to love her. Someone to hold her. Someone to watch over her. And it's pretty hard to do that when you're in a wheelchair, isn't it? Yeah, that's right. I'm going to watch over Lizzie Borden while Rob Black just sits back in his little wheelchair and can't do a thing about it. That's right. You fishies doing good? Fishies doing good?
Wait. I still don't understand where you've been.
Hysterics from Kevin on the phone, you know, about like how the house got broken into and everything. Just what? You need that? Okay.
Here you go.
Yeah, maybe later. Anyway, so you know, fill me in because I mean, first of all, how did they even like know where you live? You know, they just barge in here and just, you know, destroy things and
look
at Lizzie and.
I don't know.
I mean, you know, I'm sorry, you know, that I wasn't around, but...
Where you been? I still don't understand. Where you been?
Well, you know, it's like I told Kleinrock, you know, the medical bills and everything like that, and, you know, I just wanted to pitch in, you know, so I was doing the mad dog
thing. I can't see you. Could you come closer?
How's that?
Look, a little closer.
How's that?
Keep going.
How's that?
Whatever. Okay, what else?
So anyway, you know, I was doing like the whole promotional thing with Mad Dog, you know. They wanted me to go around different places and whatnot, you know, and it's, you know, I'm trying to help you pay the bills, you know. They're sending me off to like all these, you know, far exotic locations and stuff like that. It's pretty crazy, you know.
Where'd you go?
Well, you know, like Whittier. But anyway, you know, I'm just concerned, you know, because I leave for like a week or so and like all this stuff just like starts going down and then he tells me about, you know, the next show and I was really, I mean, Terry Funk, you know, I mean, why did you agree to that sort of thing anyway?
I didn't agree to it. Well...
Well, Kleinrock said that you made like some deal with him because you got him like last minute to take care of, you know, the camel jockey and whatnot like 2 years ago.
I don't know, man. I guess I signed a contract. I don't know. Everything's just been a...
Because, I mean, I'm just very concerned about this whole thing, you know? You breathe, breathe. Breathe.
Blur!
You breathe in.
Everything's gonna... Blur!
Blur, yeah. Well...
I don't know why. You know, I was gonna make my triumphant return. I can't come back. I'm all f***ed up again. You know, and the Kevin, he's landing this Terry Funk, you know, the Enterprise, they're getting raped, you're gone, and now there's a landmines, explosions.
Well, you know, I told the Mad Dog people that, you know, that's the end of it, because I can't go away for like 5 minutes anymore, you know, because all this stuff's going on, you know, like my whole world turns upside down, you know, and yours. You know, it's just all this crazy nonsense, you know, and he's telling me about Terry Funk and whatnot, and, you know, I'm scared out of my mind because, I mean, I get these letters all the time, you know. People aren't, like, too crazy about me, you know what I mean?
Webb, you gotta beat Terry Funk, Webb.
Well, see, that's my concern, you know, because, I mean, I get these letters from the fans and stuff like that, and they say, dear John Webb, you suck, blah, blah, blah. You know, you won the title of beating a manager and stuff like that. Your real opponents have been Leroy and Kevin Kleinrock and stuff like that. You know, and it's true, you know, because you guys, you sort of baby me, you take care of me a lot, you know? And, like, this one, I mean, you and your condition and, like, you know, Lizzie, she can barely even, like, talk to her.
Wait.
Shh. Oh, then, yeah, you need a baby wipe? You okay? Breathe. Yeah, breathe. So, yeah. Yeah, that's a bit strong. Just try to breathe. You okay? You gonna be okay? Yeah. Yeah, just... Alright, breathe. Breathe now. So, anyway, it's just like... I don't know, man. It's like, everything's like so crazy now, you know? I mean, like, I'm gonna, like, actually have to wrestle this time. You know? And it's just nuts, you know? I mean, I used to watch this guy. I mean, he's like one of the reasons why I got in business and everything like that, you know? And now I'm in this situation. It's just... Yeah, and I don't want to let you down, so, I mean, I'm really concerned, you know,
what?
But I'm going to do my best.
Hello?
Hello?
Chris Hamrick? And let me tell you something else. You suck. You're not like me.
How did you get my number?
You're never gonna be like me. And I'm gonna show you again why I'm so damn unstoppable. How did I get your number?
I'm trying to be like you. Well, who wants to be like you? You're just a loud mouth. You know, you got a little talent, but you ain't all that. And then, first of all, you turn your back on the fans. Then your cousin.
The fans. Who cares about the fans? That's where you're wrong, and that's where I'm right. That's why I have the gold, and that's why you don't. I'm the champion. You're nothing but a bitter old man. That's all that you're ever gonna be. You're never gonna be. Your sugar is never gonna be as sweet as mine.
You know what, Chaos?
What's that?
You couldn't be half of me with other half helping you, sorry ass.
Look at you. Insult. That's all you have. You can't prove anything. I showed you once in the Gauntlet match, and I'll show you again. You're not even on my level. You have no reason to step in that ring with me.
I'm going
to
hand your ass to you like it's never been handed before. What do you think about that?
That's all you got. That's all you got. Bring it on the 29th, and I'll show you why.
Hey, Chaos.
I'm going to reign victorious on the 29th.
Let me tell you something. After 29th, when I take your belt...
Hold on. Let me transfer you to my operator.
Woo! This isn't enriching, this isn't cultural, this isn't something that stimulates the mind of someone like me.
It's cultural.
Need nurture.
It is cultural, it's, you know, f***ish. Here.
Where are we going, sister, where are we going? Sister, I'm thirsty, I need a beverage. I'm feeling a bit parched. I need to quench my thirst.
I'm getting kind of tired of this. Can we go home soon?
I'm tired, worn out of this.
Oh, honey.
You and your bitch and your emotions.
Can't we just go home
back today? Can't we just go home? Some hooligan may just, like, destroy my car right now. I don't know. Just let's go.
Tired, Mike.
It's gonna be the bomb.
Here it comes.
May I have your attention, please? Y'all act like you've never seen a rapping wrestler before. Paul's all up on hordes like a stream off his doors, taking chicks to the limit upon forced entry. Stalk him in the stomach, send him down to a bent knee. It's his debut of hold up, stop the cut, right? You kidding? He didn't just say that, right, yo, he's driven. AWC said, none of you smugs, my agent's dead. Okay, he's not, he's just wasted. All the women fans, yo, they love my street style. Give him the thumbs up, have a coke and a smile. Always walk around like I'm the big shot. Flipping you the finger, always grabbing my c***. I'm the hammer, I'm the bad mamma jammer. Hope the guy don't get thrown in the slammer, cause sometimes life can suck real bad. And sometimes you wanna just beat the f*** out your dad. And sometimes you wanna jump in the ring. And sometimes you wanna just f*** lots of women. Come here, dude, I got something to tell you. You act like a f*** and you smell real bad too. Oh what, you wanna step and test my rep? I'm the guy who steal all three girls from hats and kiss them on the lips while I have bad breath. Gems down the throat till they get strapped. If you don't believe me, drop to your knees, I'll give you the truth. Got a whole bunch of sex lessons by Dr. Room. Wasn't no tooth, it was all gum. This little trick and it made me. It was fun, she was stunned, so I had to run away. Picked up the phone and I sold the toy to Dre. Cause I'm Sugar Shady, yes I'm the Sugar Shady. All you other Sugar Shadies is just perpetrating. So won't Sugar Shady Shady please stand up. Please stand up, please stand up. I'm Sugar Shady, yes I'm the Sugar Shady. All you other Sugar Shadies is just perpetrating. Won't Sugar Shady Shady please stand up. Please stand up. What?
No, yeah.
That was fat! Don't lie, y'all loved it. Y'all loved it. Alright, y'all. I'm about to go get some 40s of mushrooms. I'll be peacing out.
That's the way to do it, my man. That's the way to do it. Beautiful, baby. Beautiful.
For sure. I'm out like pogo and dodgeball.
Yo, Glenn X.
Yo, Shady.
You gotta do me a favor. You're gonna have to sweeten that up a little bit, the Osborne thing, you know what I'm talking about?
It's gonna take more than the Osborne thing.
You can do it, man. You got big money. Sweeten it up.
Do everything.
Post-production, post-studio.
Could be more Milli Vanilli work.
As long as it works, my man. As long as it works.
I'll do what I
can. Anyways, brother, Kleinrock is waiting for me. I'm dead as it is already. I got to be over at City Walk, but do me a favor. Me and you will hook it up next week, have some lunch, go down to Spago's. Right? It's on you, though. It's on you. Right?
It's on me?
It's on you, man. Hey, I made it in D.C. I seen it on TV, bro. You pick up the tab. Thanks a lot, brother. Appreciate it. Catch you, baby. What are you doing? Let's go.
I got a lot of work ahead of me.
Step! 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 Jeez, man, you're slipping. You are slipping.
Say it. No, I don't want to. You want me?
No,
you
no,
don't
no.
want
to. You say it. You say it.
Was that the worst chair shot you've ever seen in the history of professional wrestling? And then he was swinging it, and it was with all his might. That was the funniest part by itself.
Okay. Wait. Never mind the door closing,
oh,
man.
God.
Never mind.
Pumping iron.
Wait a minute. What matters is that Angel won the match, which meant it was a victory for the Black Army. And that's the direction this war seemed to be headed in.
Well, headed until genocide. Now, pal. You gotta remember, the match was set. It was the two-ring, double steel cage genocide match. It was supposed to be the Black Army's Lizzie Borden, Rob Black, Angel, Webb, and Nosawa going against the E's, Veronica Kane, GQ Money, Steve Rosano, the Sandman, and of course, Chaos. Now, of course, because of the stroke, the very unfortunate stroke of Rob Black and the kidnapping of GQ Money. Well, the match was set, of course, then to be 4-4, but at the official coin toss, the E had a very big surprise for all of us, and we saw a brand new GQ Money.
Did you see the way he had that chair and it was fumbling around? Going all different.
Paul, look at this now. Shots exchanging blows left to right here. In boot to the midsection from Chaos. Shots now continuing away. Chaos hurting his hand on that one. An Irish whip coming up. No, reversal by Angel to the near side. Look at this. Flip over, but Angel dodges it. Oh, he caught him right in the flesh of the face. And now it's Angel up top. Look at this, spinning around, going for a tornado DDT, but no, a counter into a powerbomb. from Chaos on to Angel. Angel now suffering at the head slingshot. Oh, no, no, look at this. Angel catching onto the top rope. And look at this Angel from high above going for the moonsault. And he nails Chaos.
What a move. What a move. I don't believe it. The feminine guy with a beautiful moonsault now taking Chaos to the ropes. A reversal by the TV champion. Lock of the kick. Oh, my God. Do you see that? Avoid the leg sweep. And landed with a beautiful splash.
And now a senton bomb attempt. No, a miss from both men. And oh, did you see that kick right to the head from Angel onto Chaos? Elbow drop and a miss from Angel. Another Irish whip. Angel suffering. Oh, look at this back body drop into ring number two. The first time the ring has been utilized tonight. Look at this double team effort over the top. And a big splash from GQ Money onto Angel with the assist of Chaos. And there is no pinfall, only submission in this match. And there's three titles on the line, Rico. Look at this, Angel is up top! Angel's on top of the cage!
What is he doing up there? Was he trying to get away from the action? What was he trying to do, eh?
Looks like he's trying to coax GQ Money to come up and join him. Oh, look at that raking. Webb's face is the Sandman on that steel cage. Look at this GQ Money! Oh no, he's going up to the top!
Oh! Missy Borden!
Go.
And Angel and GQ Money still fighting tooth and nail on top of the cage. And look, Lizzie, very strategically waiting. There's only one member left. That's Veronica. And there's Lizzie waiting for Veronica right at the entrance. Very smart. I mean, that's a very good game plan right there, eh?
Look at these two of them. Oh, no, now look at this Veronica Kane and Lizzie Barnett going. Oh.
Cat fight, man. That's a cat fight on the ramp, in the ramp way right there. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that.
Who's going to win this fight?
No matter what, there are no losers right there, Holmes. Look at that. Look at the show. Look at this. I don't care who wins. Just take your clothes off.
And look at all the action still going on in the ring. And on top of the ring.
Man, there's action everywhere on the floor.
On top of the cage.
Everywhere, man. Look at the action. Incredible. Look at this. Lizzie into the guardrail, man.
Lizzie Borden just went face first into that guardrail. What a... I can't say it.
Man, she's bitch slapping her, Holmes. Just say it. She's bitch slapping. Oh, look, there's Webb. There's White Trash Johnny Webb.
And that's White Trash DDT on Veronica Kane. You have got to be kidding me. Look at this. No, no, no.
Ah! He's dead. Man, Angel is dead. Romatado, man. Romatado. That's murder, man. That's a 187 right there.
And Supreme is now in the ring, battling the Enterprise. Whoa! Oh, GQ Money from the top!
That guy's crazy, man. I told you, that guy's crazy. He just took out Angel again and all the securities, man. Somebody, that guy's got to be locked up, man. Who the hell jumps willingly up a 20-foot cage? That guy is locked up.
Webb shaking the cage, shaking Chaos. Oh, no, look at this. Chaos from the top. Oh! Under the table.
Mira, man, he just pulled him down from the top of the cage to that table. Grabbed him by the ankle, man, and made him go to that table.
What a smart move that was by Webb. Literally just grabbing the ankle of Chaos and pulling him down on top of the table, onto the canvas. And look at this, Borden and Kane still going at it. Now Veronica Kane relentless, going after Lizzie Borden, pulling her hair. And it looks like she's still going for a submission.
And now Chaos choking the life out of Webb. And I look at him now, look at Borden and Veronica, man, going at it. Cat fight, man, it's a cat fight.
And look at this, there is action all over the place, all over the ring still. All factions of the Black Army, all factions of the Enterprise. And don't forget, Supreme is involved in this matchup. But where, but why, but how, I still don't know.
Well, it's my guess, man. Look, they're all going after Lizzie.
Oh, no,
they're all going after Lizzie. No, Lizzie, no. She's tapping out, man.
Wait a minute, the microphone, that's it. It's over.
I don't believe it, man, the bell rang. That's it. Wait a minute. She's not a champion.
That's right, Rico. You're exactly right. No titles have changed in this matchup.
Everyone who has come and faced Crimson has ran in fear. Anyone who has tasted my blade has run in fear. Fear of their lives. all but one man. This man seems to understand the same things that I understand. This man seems to draw his strength from the same places from which I draw my strength. Everyone who has faced Crimson is red in fear. Everyone who has tasted my blood has ran in fear. Fear of their lives! All but one man. This man seems to understand the things I understand. This man seems to draw his power, his strength, from the same places from which I draw my strength, my power. But I don't think he truly understands how far he can truly take it. I don't think he understands the freedom and joy which he can obtain through natural selection and evolution. My path has been chosen, but I feel it's my right, my obligation to show him my way, to help him achieve this next step of evolution, this higher level of consciousness. I will show him my way. My way. He will taste the blade again. And he will be set free.
Look, you little loudmouth son of a this might be running games to you. Hey, each time you call, it shows me how scared you are of losing that title on the 29th. And I'm telling you, I'm going to beat your ass so bad. Each time that you've called and aggravated me, there's that much more an ass whooping you're going to get. So on the 29th, after I take your gold, I want you to do me one favor. I want you to build a bridge.
What?
Yeah, and then one day you'll get the over it.
Get over? Get over it? You know, Chris Hamrick, I'll have nothing to get over. You're going to have something to get over. Get over the fact that I'm the champ, you're not, and you're going to go yourself.
So the Enterprise was able to pull off the victory, but the Black Army was the last team standing.
And the brutality between Veronica Kane and Lizzie Borden, I fear this is only the beginning of what seems to be an apparent war that's going to be escalating here in XPW if Lizzie finds her composure enough to actually leave her own home. And what about this Scott Snot character? I mean, it just seems like now he's taking advantage of her weakness just to spend some time with her, some swinging good times. What a sicko.
Estás en lo cierto, Chris. You're right. Scott's not is sick. There's something wrong with that guy.
Yeah, yeah. Fans, be sure to join us right here next week for episode, XPW TV's episode number 99. We're going to have more information on what's going to be coming up Saturday, June the 29th, live from the Pico Rivera Sports Arena as XPW presents Liberty or Death. More announcements, more tag teams in the tournament, more matches themselves, and I'm determined, pal, I'm determined to get to the bottom of this. What in the world will a landmine be doing at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena? What's it gonna be doing there, pal? There's gonna be a landmine there, and who knows when it's gonna go off? It could be me, it could be you, it could be anybody. I can't believe it. Where is it gonna be? You know, you probably know. Who knows? What was that? Hey, there's a bomb!
Thank you.
Yo, Kevin. It's your star attraction, AWC. I seen on TV. Bro, I'm here at City Walk. I'm right here, man. Where's the crew at? Where are the people? Supposed to be auditioning people. Bro, Shady. Bro, believe me, it's gonna be good. Shady stuff's a little weak right now, but we're gonna make it tight. We're gonna make it work. Yeah, that's why it was so late. I'm sorry, man. I know you're busy, brother. Yeah, baby, we'll do lunch, but we're gonna get it done next week for sure. I'm gonna go ahead and do some exercise on my own, get some stuff going. I'll talk to you later. That guy, man. I'm trying to hurt my artistic integrity. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Come and get me, huh? You stupid fools! It was you all along! You damn filthy ape! I'm the king of the world! I'm the king of the world!
That's right. Car's in the back.
Oh.
Perdón. Quiero hablar con Kevin Kleinrock.
Here comes the random neighbor.